Chris Masters understands that a victory here puts him right in line for a World's Heavyweight Championship opportunity.
It's the goal of every superstar to be a world champion. Masters has never climbed that mountain as he comes from the second and flew right into a huge uppercut.
Oh, the knife edge just underneath the jaw.
And now Cain keeping Masters' shoulders on the mat as he beats down on Masters' skull.
Look into the demented monster's eyes.
Cain, who takes such pleasure in others' suffering.
The masochist.
And now a perhaps merciless chokeslam is about to head Chris Masters' way. Up and down, 7 feet in the air.
When have we ever seen anyone manhandle Chris Masters in such a manner? That's a sign, direct sign to his brother, The Undertaker. It's almost eerie. It's like you know something's about to happen, and
he's gonna do it. Masters, who weighs 270 pounds, upside down for a tombstone pile driver, just like The Undertaker on Sunday night.
The cages of hell.
Another victim for Cain as his reign of terror continues.
Years of pain and torment on the face of Cain, finally vindicated from his brother's shadow.
And there was the turning point, Matt, as Cain took out Chris Masters' left knee.
And watch this uppercut right here. Oh. Knife edge just underneath the jaw, and the rest is elementary.
The choke slam, and then the tombstone pile driver, a page straight out of the dead man's playbook.
Big brother, this past Sunday, whatever of the dark side remains with you, whatever bit of powers that you still possess, you couldn't stop me. I took everything that you had to offer, and still I left behind a pile of ruins. I proved that I was the dominant brother when I dropped you on your head, crushing your skull and your legend at the same time. And now, big brother, you know better than all these weak and pathetic people here. You're no better than the millions of weak and pathetic people watching all around the universe. And do you know what makes you weak and pathetic? Huh? It's your fear. I can smell it from here. And the closer I get, the stronger the odor. You smell that? It's all around me. The stench of fear permeates this arena. Everyone here is afraid. You're afraid of the unknown. You're afraid of failure. But most of all, you are afraid of what I'm capable of. And knowing that no one can stop me anymore, I am the living, breathing embodiment of your fear. And the one thing that you want more than anything else, the one thing that you desire most in your entire lives, is that I just disappear, that I go away. But this monster's not going anywhere. Later on tonight, I have a challenge for The Undertaker that I will not allow him to deny. Big brother, this past Sunday, I may have destroyed your body, but soon enough, and on my own terms, I will destroy your legend and your very soul.
Of champions, Kane did the unthinkable by defeating The Undertaker in their no-holds-barred match for the World's Heavyweight Championship. There are exclusive photos available right now online at WWE.com. Tell us what you thought of Night of Champions at Facebook.com/WWE.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Georgia, weighing in at 223 pounds, is one half of the new WWE Tag Team Champions, Dashing Cody Rhodes.
Exquisiteness loves company, and let me introduce you to just that, my tag team partner, Drew McIntyre.
Oh, what a party they had in Drew's hometown of Ayr, Scotland. They broke out the Johnny Walker Blue, the Hot Rod t-shirts, and the skinny jeans in celebration.
The last thing I thought we'd be talking about would be skinny jeans.
Can you name a better looking tag team champion, maybe other than the legendary Graham Brothers, Dashing Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre?
When you say good looking, do you mean physical appearance or their work rate inside?
Both.
The ring?
Everything. These guys are complete.
Well, Matt, they're two great individuals, but